Welcome back, Algebra fans. We're talking word problems again. This time we're talking consecutive integers. What does this word mean? Consecutive. It just means one after the other, right? So on our number line, remember this is our number line. Our number line goes from negative infinity to positive infinity with a zero right in the middle, right? So consecutive integers means that they're in order. They're one after the other. So three consecutive integers would be like 1, 2, and 3. They are in a row, okay? Now, you can have consecutive integers in the positive, or you could have consecutive integers in the negative, -1, -2, -3, or -7, 8, 9, or negative whatever, right? In addition to that, you could have something like consecutive even integers, which would be like 2, 4, 6, right? Those are consecutive even integers, or like consecutive negative integers, consecutive negative odd integers. How about that? -17, -19, -21, right? Those are three consecutive negative odd integers. That's a lot of constraints on our integers there, isn't it? So how can you work word problems with consecutive integers? They are quite easy, actually. Okay, let's look at a problem. This problem here says, find the sum of four consecutive even integers, okay? So we know that they're not just in a row, but they're the evens, or the 2, the 4, the 6, is 52. So the sum, what does the sum mean? Sum means we're gonna add, right? And then is, of course, is means equal, okay? So the sum of four consecutive integers, if I add four consecutive even integers together, they should equal 52. Find those integers. Okay, now, the weak student would be like this. Oh, well, there's four integers. There's, let's call it A, B, C, D is equal to 52, okay? The problem with this is it has 1, 2, 3, 4 unknowns. If you have four unknowns, you have to use four equations to solve for those four unknowns. You can't solve that. You don't know what it is. So since we only have one equation, we only need one unknown, right? So what do we know about this? So since we're talking about, let's say 52 is going to be positive integers, okay? This is a positive 52. What do we know about those integers? Let's just take one variable. Let's call him A, okay? So if A, let's say, is the smallest of the four consecutive even integers. So A is the littlest guy. He's the smallest one. Then B, the next one in line, how big is he going to be? You know how big he's going to be? He's going to be A plus, right? If we're talking 2, how many do you have to go to get to 4? 1, 2, right? So he's A plus 2. What is C equal to? What is C? C is A plus 4, isn't he? And what is D? He's A plus 6. And that has to equal 52. You see what we did there? And when we solve for A, what is A? A is going to be the littlest one. So then what is B, C, and D? Well, we can do this, right? B is equal to A plus 2. C is equal to A plus 4. D is equal to A plus 6, right? So we can go back, once we get A, we can go back and we can get the rest of these guys easy as pie, right? Let's see if we can solve for A. Now, since there's no negatives, the distributive property that we're used to using, we don't need it here. We can just erase these parentheses, okay? If we had a negative in front of there, we'd have to distribute the negative. But since this is a positive 1 in front of our parentheses, 1 times A is A, 1 times 2 is just 2, right? We don't have to do any kind of distributive manipulation there. Okay, let's group things, okay? Let's group the A's together. How many do we have? 1 plus 2, 1, 2, 3, 4 of them. So 4A plus, now let's group the integers together, 2 plus 4 is 6, and 6 plus 6 is 12, is equal to 52, okay? Now, we're going to get that to the other side, right? So 4a equals 52 minus 12, and 52 minus 12 is 40, right? And let's divide both sides by 4, divided by 4, divided by 4, right? The 4s go away, and so I get a is equal to what's 40 divided by 4? 10, okay? So what are our 4 consecutive integers for this problem? Well, a is 10, b is 12, c is 14, and d is 16. So we put it in our calculator and we add up that and that and that and that, we should get 52, do we? 16 and 14 is 30, and that's 42 plus 10 more is 50. Yeah, baby, we got it, right? All right, let's go one more over here. This one's gonna be harder. This next one, we're finding the sum of 3, not that one over there was 4, odd integers. Let's talk for a second about this number here. If you add 2 consecutive integers together, right? If I add 2 odds together, what do I have to get? If I add 7 plus 7, what do I get? An even, right? 2 odds equal an even, always, okay? 2 evens added together still give you an even number, don't they? Okay? So, if I add 3 together, if I add 3 negatives together, 2 of the negatives would make it an even, but then when I add another negative to it, it goes back to odd again, okay? So this is going to be, it's possible to find this answer. Okay, so here we go. The sum of 3 consecutive integers, 3 consecutive odd negative integers. So I'm going to call this A plus B plus C equals negative 87. Because you might be thinking, well, why isn't that negative A plus negative B plus negative C? Remember, A just stands for some unknown, and that unknown could be positive or negative. We don't know. So we'll find that when we solve this problem, what A is. Is A positive or negative? But right now, A just represents a positive number. So remember, the sum means plus 3 consecutive odd integers is 87, which is equal to 87. Find the integers, okay? So just like we did over here, A is equal to some number. So what is B going to be equal to? Well, it's going to be equal to A plus 2, and C equals A plus 4. Now, the most important thing is for you to understand, what is A? Okay, if A is a negative number, and I add 2 to it, then I'm going to get what? Because if A is, like, on the number line is down here, and I add 2 to it, 1, 2, right? I'm going to have a smaller number. So A is going to be the biggest negative integer. So of these consecutive integers, this guy is the biggest negative odd integer, okay? So when we solve for A, he's going to be the farthest that way down the number line, okay? And then the next two, B and C, are going to be one back and then one back from that, right? Okay, so here we go. Let's substitute in just like we did over here. So A plus 2 plus C is A plus 4. And again, I don't need any parentheses because I have a positive there for my distributive property, equals negative 87. Okay, just like we did before, let's do a little grouping. Okay, A and A and A is 3 A's. And then our numbers, we got 2 plus 4 is 6. Equals negative 87, okay? So to take the 6 to the other side, I need to subtract 6 from both sides, right? And a negative and another negative makes a bigger negative, right? So negative 87 and 6 more is 93 to the negative equals 3a. Divide both sides by 3, okay? So a is equal to, let's see, 3 goes into 3 one time, and 3 goes into 9 3 times, so that's negative 31, okay? So if A is negative 31, then what's B? Plus 2. Okay, I got a negative and I add two positives to it, right? It gives me what? Negative 29, and this guy, negative 27. Okay, so there's our three consecutive numbers. 1, 2, 3. And if I add those three together, want, they should give me 87. Okay, do they? Let's see. 29 and 27 is 49, 56. This is 56. And 56 plus 31 is 87. It's negative 87 indeed, isn't it? Should put a negative there, right? So there's our three consecutive numbers. So don't think that you need to have an unknown for each one of those. Just have one in the series and then just add to that one to get the other ones, because we know they're consecutive, right? Okay, this isn't too bad. Hope this helps. See you next time.